Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So we're removing her old set. So I just clipped them with clippers, the free edge, and then I'm using my drill bit to remove the acrylic as far as I can get it without touching the natural nail. So I'm gonna leave some acrylic left, but I'm gonna remove most of it. So when we remove it, it's easier to soak her. We're not trying to soak off a whole bunch of acrylic. It's really thin. So I just use my drill bit, thin it down, the acrylic, after I clipped them. Then she'll go into a bowl of acetone, and then I will push off, when she comes out of the acetone, I'll push off the excess acrylic that's left. We'll push back her cuticles, clean under her nails with an orange wood stick, remove shine, and basically do our prep work. And I'll let you know when we get to the next step. All right, so after she soaked in the acetone for like 10 minutes, then she came out and I pushed off the acrylic like I'm doing right here. Then I just push back the cuticles, clean under the nails with an orange wood stick. We're gonna remove shine and shape up the free edge. So I'm removing shine with my drill bit, but I'm using a certain, I'm showing you these sanding bands. These are the ones I most definitely recommend. I don't recommend the 180s, which a lot of people use. My preference, and what I'm gonna say I prefer to use, is these. See, my drill is on the lowest speed, and this is a 240, so it's very, very gentle. So as long as you don't put pressure on the nail, on your drill, pushing on it, same with your file. If you're using a 240 file, but you keep filing over and over and over in the same spot, and you're doing it really hard, it's gonna, of course, get to your nail and damage it. Same thing with your drill bit. If you're doing it lightly, and you're not pressing on the nail, but you're using a 240, you're not gonna have any damage to the natural nail. But this is the only bit I use. I don't use the 180. I feel that's a little bit too rough, in my opinion. I think that it overfiles a little bit, no matter what. That's my opinion, and I may be wrong, but I won't use it on me. I only use 240s on the natural nail. And these bits are perfect because they're 240. So I got these off eBay, and they were only $6.95 for 100 of them. So we're shaping up the free edge after we removed the shine. Now I'm just shaping it up with my 240, and we're gonna do our gel application on natural nails. All right, so one more thing. The reason why we removed the shine on her natural nails is because we had acrylics on top. I wanted a clean base, basically, to put the gel on top. Usually, you would just want to buff it with a buffer, but being that she had acrylic on there, it was too much stuff stuck on her nail. I wanted it off so the gel polish would adhere right and look better, not all bumpy with the parts of the acrylic that was still stuck that a buffer wouldn't get off. All right, so now I'm just wiping off all the dust. Then I'm gonna go into my alcohol and clean all the nails really well. We don't wanna put gel polish on top of dust, so clean them real well. Then I'm going into Madame Glam's base coat, and we're gonna put base on all the nails. And then I'm gonna do a technique called dry brushing. So after she goes into the lamp for 30 seconds in an LED and comes out of the lamp, I'm gonna use a dry gel brush to wipe off the excess gel on the nail. All right, so I've applied base. She went into the light for 30 seconds. Now I got a dry gel brush and see how I'm wiping off the gel right here? So there's excess still left on there and I'm just removing it off. Next, I'm going into our colors. So this is a new color I got from Madame Glam. It's beautiful, it's got like a shimmer to it. So we're using this for one of our colors. This is the one we're gonna do a marble design on. So I do two coats of this color. Then I'm using NOQ. I'm gonna leave all the colors and their names in the description box. Then this is the only one color that I'm using from NOQ. And it's like a beige, I guess. Real pretty color. So I do two coats of this. And then we go into, I believe it's a silver. It's a shimmer silver, real pretty. And that's from Madame Glam. And we do two coats of this one. This is it right here. Really beautiful color. So we do two coats this color, this shimmer gold silver type. It's got like gold and silver in it, I think. It's just really pretty. So we do two nails like this. We do two orange nails. One we leave plain orange, and then we do one of the NOQ color nails. So two coats on each, except for the ones that we're gonna do our marbling on. All right, so I was just cleaning up around the cuticle right there. You don't want to go into the lamp with any gel around on the skin. So now I'm using Madame Glam's top coat, and I'm using the no wipe top gel. So we don't have to even remove the sticky layer on top. They're already done when she comes out of the lamp. Then we're going to work on our two marble nails. All right, so this is the two nails that we marbled. So I applied one coat of the color. Then I go in and I get white and I make some dots like you see me doing right here. And then I get the same orange color, make some more little dots, just like two or three. I go into 99% alcohol. I think mine was maybe 97 or something, but I don't use a cherry alcohol. I use one that's more higher. So I go into some alcohol with a little striper type brush and I start marbling it. If you see what I'm doing, I'm using the alcohol as it's making this spread. It's making our gel spread. So that's what I'm doing. And then I'll go add some more little dots, okay? Until I get that right look I'm looking for. Then I'll even get my striper and make like a stripe, like right here with the gel color. And when I get the look I want, like right here, into the lamp she goes for 30 seconds. Then we top coat and we were finished with our marble. Thank you. All right, guys, quick note. So on the marble nails, like this one I'm doing right here, when I put base, cure her in the lamp for 30 seconds in an LED. If you have a UV, you would go longer. After the base, I do one coat of color. After that one coat of color, she goes into the lamp. So when she comes out and that first coat's cured, then we will do the dots. So take note, first color you lay, you want to cure. All right, guys, and I actually made this dome with the same colors that's on her nails. And I put like a little dry flower in there, some gold leaf. Here's our final results. And the mold, it's called Patico, I think. They're in Japan. I ordered it straight from Japan. But you can get them. I seen Daily Charm has them. And they're like $7 or $8, and they're jewelry molds, and they're really neat, and you can make domes. They have different shapes. I think there's 4 boxes with different shapes in them. So it's really neat, guys. You'll love it. And I'll show you how to make those in a next video. But thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys, and see you in the next one.